Stone Age occurred. Remember, during BC, years were counted down, not up. So 10,000 BC came before 9,000 BC.
Now, the Stone Age began in 700,000 BC. That's a pretty long time ago.
The Stone Age was made up of three parts, the Paleolithic, the Old Stone Age, the Mesolithic, the Middle Stone Age, and the Neolithic, the New Stone Age.
It all started at the end of the Ice Age. Richard began to warm up. People returned to the lab for the first time to get up mammals, such as reindeer and Arctic cat. This was the start of the Paleolithic era.
Around 9,500 BC, the second era called the Mesolithic begins. The land continues to warm up and the cold, dry habitat was replaced by woodlands.
Forest creatures such as reindeer and wildcats were hunted by bow and arrow.
The Neolithic era began around 4,000 BC when evidence of early farming people appeared.
It was between 2,000 and 3,000 BC when the pyramids of ancient Egypt were built. The Bronze Age in Britain had just begun.
The Iron Age years in 800 BC in Britain, then we get to years when Jesus was born.
Then came the Romans in Britain between 43 AD and 410 AD.
Next came the Tudors, followed by the Victorians, which Paul Ford told us all about in their brilliant club assembly.
In 1914, the First World War broke out, followed by the Second World War in 1935.
Finally, we are here in present day at just over 2,000 years since the beginning of the Christian era.
So, we know all this happened a very long time ago. But was life so different for a Stone Age family? Let's find out.
I'm one of your hosts, Destiny Marshall Reed.
And I'm Angelika Kowalska. Let's welcome our guests.
Our two families today have travelled millions of years from the past to be with us today.
Our first family has all the way from the Paleolithic era. Let's welcome Grub Crude and the Crude family.
Our second family is slightly more modern. Hailing from the Neolithic era is Fred Flintstone and the Flintstone family.
What's life like to live in Paleolithic?
Great, we lived in caves in our valley.
We were fur bandit and crazy friends.
Plus, we fought bear owls.
A great first round, Crude. Let's meet our second family, the Flintstones.
I'm Fred Flintstone. Yabba-dabba-doo! Nice to meet you.
What was life like in the Neolithic era, Flintstone?
Well, we're far more modern than the Crudes.
We live in much more than dingy, smelly caves.
Whose caves are you calling smelly?
Be nice, ladies.
But it is true, though. We were far more advanced than our Paleolithic cousins. We lived in huts and discovered more of the world and began farming rather than just hunting food.
Well, that leads us to our first question. Both teams have your buzzers ready.
Name a Stone Age animal.
Easy, woolly mammoth.
Stacy tiger.
Woolly rhinoceros found in Africa.
Megalosaurus.
What is a megalosaurus? Is it a dinosaur?
What's a dinosaur? We didn't have them in Stone Age. A megalosaurus is a giant deer with deadly antlers. Well, that leads us to our second question. What tools appeared to help families during the Stone Age?
We created nets to catch fish.
We made flint knives.
We made stone axes and hammers.
We also invented pottery, including cooking pots.
That's it! I've had enough with those Neolithic chumps. They think they're better than us.
That's because we are.
Calm down. You're both great Stone Age families.
Well, we have one final question. How did the Stone Age people communicate with each other?
We used pictures and symbols.
We created thousand cave paintings to mess with rose that came after.
Yes, and we added to those cave paintings. Yes, never do!
What did you paint?
Stone Age family fortunes.
Close your eyes and bow your heads for our prayer.
We hope you enjoyed learning about